God give me a revelation. I demand the attention of Jesus. One of them said that the devil put Jesus in the up of the temple. I said to Jesus, jump. Because the angels will protect you. And the bones will not broke. And I see what was happening. This was not my emotions. This was not my mind. It was an attack of the devil. So I said, it's written, don't tempt your God. Don't tempt, like Jesus said, don't tempt your God. And these suicidal thoughts was cut with that verse. Because the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 6, the sword of the Spirit. The word of God. I decided to fast and pray 2 days per week. Asking God to give me strength, spiritual strength. I read Bible during hours. God give me strength. And then I pray daily for the people who want to commit suicide. A director of missions told me that in Spain there are 5,000 people who commit suicide every day. Not every year.
In Spain,
and during these years, God put in my way different people who want to commit suicide. I give my testimony to them. How God helped me to go out of suicide thoughts. And how God helped me. How God helped me. And these people was restored. I give my testimony in a vision in the night with different churches. And there was 2 young people who have suicide thoughts. And they came to me and said, Valerio, help us.
Amen.
We don't know, we have suicide thoughts and we don't know how to let that thought. And I give them my testimony and I pray to them. I encourage them to pray because of spiritual warfare. One day I came in a bridge to pass to go to the study in the library. It was about 10:30 in the night in summer. And in another part of the bridge, when he's going the car, a young people told me, Valerio, come and help me because he wants to commit suicide. Come help me because this person wants to commit suicide. It was 30 meters of distance. And this person already wants to jump. And because the other friend wants to help him to don't jump. So in that moment came in my mind. I began to speak in tongues. And I say, spirit of suicide, go out of him. In the name of Jesus Christ. I was 30 meter distance. When I said that, the person want to jump to suicide. He fell down. But he fell full like a stone. I ran until the place he went. He was. And I was very impacted because never in my life I think that exists a spirit of suicide. Never. In my church, where I go all my life, they never talk about the spirit of suicide.
Fact,
so So it was a revelation for me. The Bible says that they bring to Jesus people who are demons. And Jesus said, demons, go out by name. And the people fall down. And maybe they fall down in knees. They are called in different ways. I don't mind. And they was free. Jesus was not Baptist. Was not Pentecostal. Was not Catholic. Was Jesus Christ. Was a Jewish. And even so, it's not about denominations. It's about putting in practice God's word. Putting in practice the walking with the Holy Spirit. I don't like there are so many denominations all over the world. And all of them, they take just some verses of the Bible. And all the verses, and they make the denomination. God wants us to believe in all Bible, not just in some verses, not just in the verses we want, not just in the verses we like, but in all Bible. So I give that testimony that during these years, so that person fall down, then get up. After sunset, he get up. He go near the.
Passa 10 segundos.
And I ask him, what do you want to commit suicide? Do you lose your girlfriend? Do you lose your job? But before that, he told me, shouting, give me a reason to live. This shout touched my heart forever. Imagine yourself, you go in Tirana, passing a bridge, and you see a person want to jump. And you say, spirit of suicide, go out of here. And he fall down, not from the bridge, but in the bridge. You are very impacted because you never see that in your life. You go, and this person, after some seconds, he stand up. And he shouted to you. Give me a reason to live. So with this question I say to you, the human beings, there are millions of people in the earth who need Jesus. Who need God. Who have different problems, different situations. A lot of people in all the world commit suicide. I heard some years ago in 2009 in America, a box talk take a pistol, I say arm.
Yeah.
And put a gun and put a gun in the his kids, kill the kids, then kill himself. Because he lost all the company. For him the money was God. When he lost his company, he lost his God. So he killed him and his family. So with all these testimonies, I want you can think and be conscious of the needs of Christ in the city. There are millions of people around the world who are different spiritual situations. Spiritual warfare, depression, anxiety, fears. There are people who have cancer, different situations. There are people who die because they don't have food to eat. So God wants us to go and to be His servants. God bless you. Sorry if I lost a little large. But when the pastor gave me time, I just flow. I can preach 1 hour more, but I prefer to stop. God bless you.
We have to talk with our pastor.
Another day. I want to pray for you all. If you have a sickness, if you need a miracle, or sick, or you have pain, just put your hand in the part you have the pain. Or the sickness. I will pray now for healing. Because I believe in that. I believe in that. And I believe in that. Yeah, I believe. So just put your hand in the part of the body you have a sickness or a pain. And I will pray for you. So you can stand up and we will pray. Holy Spirit, touch this pain. Touch this sickness. Every pain of their bodies, I pray to go out. Now, in the name of Jesus Christ, every heart, I pray to be healed. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, bring healing in the bodies, in the soul, in the emotions, in the mind, in the heart. Let your healing, Father. Let your miracles. And more than that, Father, give them boldness and passion to preach the gospel, to take Christ to their families, to their classrooms, to their jobs, to the nations, in Tirana, in Albania, and in the nations. I pray that, Father, in the powerful name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So, who from here, I have a question. Who from here want to serve God? Who is willing to serve God with the gifts that God gave him? Come here. This is the calling of prayer. Yeah.